Good morning. My name is Judit Kőszegi, and my research and also my business idea is related to the topic of software maintenance. I am working on the same project as the previous presenter, but I would like to explain how my PhD research connects to this project, and I would like to append some thoughts to our business idea too. So, software maintenance includes all of the modification that made after the software delivered, and we can distinguish different kinds of maintenance tasks, like finding and fixing bugs, adapting the product to a modified environment, or improve the performance or other attributes, or just make the source code nicer and more readable in order to be easier maintainable. So it is very important for a developer team to find proper methods and tools that can help them in these maintenance tasks because approximately three-quarters of the whole budget is spent to the maintenance phase during the software life cycle. There are some programming languages, the most popular programming languages, for which there exists professional maintenance supporting tool. But there are some emerging programming languages, like Erlang, for which there isn't any. So that's why we chose at the university 6 years ago the Erlang language, which is used for concurrent, fault-tolerant, highly available applications like telecommunication applications, chat servers, or database systems. So we started to work on a project called Refactorer, and we developed a tool that can statically analyze Erlang source code and offer features that can help programmers in daily code comprehension tasks. And we also support the so-called refactoring transformations. And after we joined to the FP7 project, we also aim to make it possible to transform a sequential code, a sequential program, to a parallel program without changing its meaning, but making it faster in a given multi-core environment. And this is the project, and I personally participating in the development of both analysis and transformations. But my new and most important task now is to find a proper formalism for the transformation steps in order to be able to precisely define what a transformation step does with the code. And hopefully we will be able to reason about our transformations and prove that the transform code preserves its meaning. And I am sure that if it is successful, the trust in our tool will be increased. And as mentioned, we have an industrial partner who gives us advices and tests our tool, but it remained an academic project so far. But as Daniel mentioned, we slowly realized the business potential in it, and we started to develop the business model for our tool. And the first idea was to sell the tool as a software product, but after we started to develop the new features connecting to the parallelization, we changed our idea because these features are quite complex and need a background information. So our new idea is to offer a service where a customer gives us his source code and the needed information for the parallelization, for example, what is the platform where the program will run, and we apply the transformations and test or prove whether it preserves its functionality and then give the transform code back to the customer. So this is our new idea, and we would like to refine this idea and hope that it will be realized. And here is some, but I would like to say some words about my future plans. So I would like to accomplish the business development experience phase in a company that works with the Erlang programming language. And then maybe I would like to continue my career in my university because I love academic atmosphere, I love teaching, and I really hope that I will be able to improve the connections between my university and the industrial partners using the knowledge I gain from the ETI City Labs.
Thank you very much. Do you have a question for you? Yes. You mentioned that you want to formalize the transformation.
Yep.
Do you mean invent a language to express the transformation rules and be able after that to prove?
Maybe one idea, because we have a semantic program graph that represents the source code. The transformation can formalized by graph rewriting rules, for example. Yeah. But I am not ready with the idea, so.
And how do you prove the preservation of the meaning of a program?
Yes, we need the semantics of the programming language and the programming constructs, and yes, we have to formalize the transformation steps with the, including the meaning of the.
Yeah. I don't know whether there exists, I would say, a graph semantic of Erlang. So you can apply your transformation on the graph of writing and preserve the meaning. So
I know it's a very
It's a huge task.
Yeah, I know it.
I think this is a really interesting point because you know the D language and the D method. Mm. It has a really formal description, and all the modification, all the refinement, you can prove and you can obtain something. So I think from this point of view, it's really, really interesting. Can you go back please to the slide where there are some things in the bottom? Because I had a very nice question, but instead of the nice question, I say my feeling that I like program, but I like program small programs, because I think that nowadays, that is your problem also, that problem of many people, that if the program is getting bigger, the way we use the computer to program line by line and type, it's and manipulate the programs line by line, it doesn't work at all. That's why we're using all the transformation tools. But I think these automatic transformations, it's just we click on a button and it transforms. In my dreams, I would imagine much better, much more a program where I can manipulate my hands. Okay, I split in two, I say, okay, take off all the something in a module, and then I put more something here. That's, so I think that much more interactive manipulations would be very, very interesting and very, very good for this program. If the source code transformation may ask me questions, it's a kind of dialogue that, okay, you are sure that you want to do that because I can do this like this or like that. I suggest do this because it would improve the performance like that. But if you have a 4-core processor, then do rather that because it's...
Yeah, our tool is interactive and there is also a possibility to reject the transformation.
Of course. And what is at the lower right part of the slide, for me it's really interesting what we discussed, that if you can formalize the program, you can formalize the transformations, and you can even reason on that why this transformation is good, then it opens very, very huge opportunities, I think, that we can really, really improve our programs and much more understandable programs. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.